Christmas. I just want to say a couple of things I like about you. Well, you're always such a good artist, so when me and Grace want to face paint and play a game, we can. And it's really fun that we can have access to face paint. And you're such a really good mom, and I feel really nice when I cuddle with you at night and we watch Extreme Home Makeover. And I also like you because you prepared the best salami and provolone sandwiches ever. Thanks, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Merry Christmas. Here's some things that I like about you. Well, I'd have to say I really like the lunch you give me for school, and I like watching movies with you on the couch on the big screen that Dad brings home with the projector. I also like it when you read books to me and Nick, and when you take me, Nick, and Murillo, and lots of other people to movies. Thanks, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Merry Christmas. Thank you for being so kind with me. Thank you for making me feel at home. Thank you for taking me to the movies with the kids sometimes and picking me up. And thank you for making the Brazilian dish. And that's it. Thank you.
She ain't got your love anymore.
Rumor has it. 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 Rumor has it.
She is half your age, but I'm guessing that's the reason that you stay. Whispered in my ear, tell a story that I cannot bear to hear. Just 'cause I said it, it don't mean that I meant it. People say crazy things just 'cause I.
Ski for a He's gotta wear his goggles close, the snow really flies, and he's cruising every path with a little surprise. It's the little Saint Nick. It's the little Saint Nick.
If I could wander through the sands of time, where would I ever find a man like this? No man's like this. No finer man will ever live. A man who has so much to give. So much to share, who's always there to light my way through every day. He has a soul to make the angels sing. His courage, warmth, and grace melt winter into spring. He weaves a magic spell no man can. Life's carousel, or turn life's tide, one half as well. A man who dedicates each day to righting wrongs he loves to right, to fighting dragons that he lives to fight, and turning darkness into light. No. Assess his worth, a man so far beyond compare, that I thank God that he is there. In time to come, as I look back on life, I know I'll know no man with his attack on life. This man I've loved since life began.
You all know the Bible is made of testaments old and new. You've been told it's just those two parts, or only one if you're a Jew. But what if I were to tell you there's a fresh third part out there, which was found by a hip new prophet who had a little Donny Osmond flair.
Back to biblical times, 1823. An American man named Joe living on a farm in the Holy Land of Rochester, New York.
You mean the Mormon prophet Joseph Smith?
That's right, that young man spoke to God.
He spoke to God?
And God said, Joe, people really need to know that the Bible isn't two parts. There's a part three to the Bible, Joe. And I, God, have anointed you to dig up this part three that is buried by a tree on the hill in your backyard.
Wow, God says go to your backyard and start digging. That makes perfect sense.
Joseph Smith went up on that hill and dug where he was told. And deep in the ground, Joseph found shining plates of gold.
What are these golden plates? Who buried them here and why?
Then appeared an angel. His name was Moroni.
I am Moroni.
The All-American Angel.
All-American.
My people lived here long, long ago.
Don't let anybody see these plates except for you. They're only for you to see. Even if people ask you to show the plates to them, don't. Just copy them onto normal paper. Even though this might make them question if the plates are real or not, this is sort of what God is going for.
Joseph took the plates home and wrote down what he found inside. He turned those plates into a book, then he rushed into town and cried.
Hey, God spoke to me and gave me this blessed ancient tome. He commanded me to publish it and stick it in every home.
Wow, so the Bible is actually a trilogy and the Book of Mormon is Return of the Jedi? I'm interested.
Now, many people didn't believe the prophet Joseph Smith. They thought he'd made up this part three that was buried by a tree on the hill in his backyard.
Liar!
But Joe said,
this is no lie. I speak to God all the time, and he told me to head west. So I'll take my part three from the hill with the tree. Feel free if you'd like to come along with me to the promised land.
The promised land?
Paradise on the west coast. Nothing but fruit and fields as far as the eye can see.
Have you heard of the All-American prophet? He found a brand new book about Jesus Christ. We're following him to paradise. We call ourselves Mormon, and our new religion is All-American.
Wow, how much does it cost?
The Mormons kept on searching for that place to settle down, but every time they thought they'd found it, they got kicked out of town. And even though people wanted to see the golden plates, Joseph never showed.
It's in my scrotum.
Okay. Well, anyway, now comes the part of our story that gets a little bit sad. On the way to the promised land, Mormons made people mad. Joseph was shot by an angry mob and knew he'd soon be done.
You must lead the people now, my good friend, Brigham Young. Oh God, why are you letting me die without having me show people the plates? They'll have no proof I was telling the truth or not. They'll have to believe it just 'cause, oh, I guess that's kind of what you were going for.
The prophet Joseph Smith died for what he believed in. But his followers, they kept heading west. And Brigham Young led them to paradise, a sparkling land in Utah they called Salt Lake City. And there,
The Mormons multiplied and made big Mormon families, generation to generation, until finally, they made me. And now it's my job to lead you where those early settlers were led long ago.
Christmas. Yes, it's Christmas.